Hi guys, welcome to Contents All. Today we're gonna see the unboxing and small review of the new Moto G, that is Motorola Moto G Generation 2. In 2013, Motorola released two incredible handsets, Moto G and Moto X, into the Android market by competing with the smartphone manufacturing giants. And now they are back with Moto G and Moto X in 2014 also. This device looks similar to 2013 Moto G, but in size and performance it varies. So let us now go and see the unboxing of the Motorola Moto G Generation 2 2014 device. So here on the box you can see it is mentioned as Motorola Moto G Generation 2, which is a 16GB variant, and it comes with around some 12,999 rupees in the Flipkart, which you can order on the online. So as you can see on the box, it is mentioned, some of the specifications are mentioned on the box. So this comes with 5-inch HD display, stereo speakers and an 8-megapixel camera. And the curved design fits comfortably in your hand with colorful Motorola shells, available at different styles to match your style. It's built with Corning Gorilla Glass display, a long life battery and water resistant coating, plus with a powerful Qualcomm Snapdragon 400 processor. So here this is the box, so let us now go and check out the unboxing of this device. So I'm just opening the device right now. So here you can see the device. This device comes with a 5-inch display having a resolution of 720 pixel and 294 ppi. And next, it comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 400 processor and a quad-core CPU, 1200 MHz processor, and Adreno 305 GPU with 1 GB of RAM and 16 GB inbuilt storage and micro SD expandable up to 32 GB. So here, as you can see, the headphones are quite good and the build quality is also good. Here you can see on the mic you have a Motorola symbol. And on the headphones also you can see the Motorola symbols over here. So these are pretty good to listen the songs. And the charger, they did not change the charger for the Motorola Moto G in the Generation 2 in 2014 also. I don't know why they have not changed the charger in with USB 1, but for Moto X they are giving this. And here you can see some bunch of manuals. So this is what regarding the unboxing is. So let us now go and check the video. So this Motorola Moto G comes with 5-inch display, and on the front you have the stereo speakers. The quality of the stereo speakers is pretty good. I listened to the songs and everything. Those are very pretty fine. And on the front you have 2-megapixel camera, and on the top you have 3.5mm jack to listen to the songs with your headset. And on the bottom you have the charging point for the USB mini USB port. And on the right hand side you can see the power button and the volume rockers. So even though the device looks a little bit thin, but the build quality is very good. So as you can say, the handset is quite handy in the hand. It looks very good. So let us now go and check the by removing the back panel and see what's inside. So here you can see two slots are available for the two dual SIMs, SIM1 and SIM2. And on the top you can see space for inserting your SD card, which is expandable up to 32 GB. And here you can see the flash and 8-megapixel camera, the rear camera, and the battery is not removable, and the capacity of the battery is 2070 milliamps of battery. So let us now go and check the first power boot of the Motorola Moto G Generation 2 and check what are the default Android OS which we get with this device. So the same boot icon for the Motorola Moto G also in 2014. They haven't changed any boot logo for this device. Everything looks similar. If you have already seen the Motorola Moto G in 2013, everything looks similar, but the display and some features they have changed. So you can see you can have a very good experience with this Motorola Moto G Generation 2 device. So here I'm just skipping all the account setup and everything. I don't want to set it up right now. I'll set it up later. So now let us go to the settings and check what is the default OS which comes with this device. So I think this device comes with Android 4.4.4 KitKat version by default, which they have mentioned on the box itself. So here you can see it is already KitKat. So here you can see it's Android 4.4.4 KitKat. So I'm just going back now, and I'm just checking for the system updates. Since I did not configure or connected to the internet, it is not showing any updates, and even then the phone is also updated right now. And let us now check the default storage size which we got. We got around some 12 GB of space, around out of 16 GB, and here you can see the SD card slot. If you have inserted the SD card, we can see the space of SD card also over here. And now here I'm checking the full brightness, medium brightness, and the without brightness, how the screen looks when with the auto brightness also. So I'm just checking with the different types of settings in the brightness, so how the screen looks. I think even the screen is even the device is capable of, we can able to see the device even in the bright sunlight also. The display is quite good. And now let us go and check the camera also. And here I can say the camera improvement for this device is quite good when compared with 2013 device camera quality or the picture quality. So right now I just zoomed it to full 4x this thing, and after that I just clicked one picture. So let us go and check after that what is the clarity of the images. So here you can see HD 720 pixel and two modes, and this is the panorama mode, and all the options are looking similar, but in the video you can see some small type of difference in the video recording. See, in the resolution you can see for widescreen 6 megapixel 16:9, and for standard 8 megapixel. If you want to for a 16:9 widescreen images, 6 megapixel images will be coming, and for normal standard one you can record it with 8 megapixel camera. So I'm just want to check the images, how they look. I'll just zoom it and I'll also show you how the clarity of the picture is. And here, as you can see, I'm just zoomed it fully, and here you can see the letters are also pretty clear. So the image quality is absolutely perfect on this device. So, and we need to just check and compare with other devices in this range also. But in this range, this is the best Android phone I can say in the market right now, with for 14,000 rupees or $179 or $180, you cannot get a very good phone like this in the Android market. It is competing with all the top phone flagship phones. So here you can see the specifications. It comes with Android 4.4, the resolution 720 pixel, and right here it is showing the screen display as 320 dpi, and the battery temperature, battery level, the temperature of the phone, and different types of sensors. Everything you can see in this application. It's a very good application. I just use some CPU-Z application. So as you can see here, it's showing 320 dpi and 851 MB of RAM is free, and this comes with 1 GB of RAM and Cortex A7 1.19 GHz processor. So that's it guys, thanks for watching, and please do like, hit like and subscribe. And if you like my videos, please do comment below. And guys, don't forget to watch these two videos. On the left hand side, you see Asus Zenfone 5 unboxing and the small review of the Asus Zenfone 5. And on the right hand side, you can see the Motorola Moto G Takewood skin pasting, that is Cruiser Light Takewood skin unboxing and review. And how does it look on your Motorola Moto G? This can be used for the new Motorola Moto G 2014 also. That is the one which is in video is 2013 one. That's it guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Please do subscribe. Enjoy.